It's Miss Becky again. Got one more story to tell you about Elijah. Now you remember, Elijah was God's prophet, which means he was chosen by God to help lead his people. And God spoke directly to Elijah. He was the voice of God to all people. Now at the end of our story last week, things were kind of looking up, don't you think? Remember, it was the story of the two altars, one for Baal and one for God. And the first one to set fire to their altar would prove he was the real God. And we know who that was, don't we? It wasn't Baal, was it? Unfortunately, not everyone was convinced by that, though. Now, King Ahab's wife was named Jezebel. And if we thought King Ahab was bad, Jezebel was too. And she had believed in Baal all her life, and no fiery altar was going to change her mind. She was still very believing in Baal. In fact, she was very, very angry at Elijah. She had sent word out through all of Canaan for him to stop talking about this God, and she was out to get him. So, poor Elijah, he's in danger again, and he has to leave Canaan again. And he didn't just walk out, he ran out. He ran almost 300 miles. And it wasn't ravens that brought him food and drink this time. It was angels. Two different times God sent angels to him when he knew Elijah was especially hungry and tired. And they came and they brought him food and water and took care of him for a few days. Well, after 40 days of running, Elijah found a cave that he decided he would stay in for a while. During one night, he heard the voice of God, and the voice said, "Elijah, what are you doing here?" And Elijah said, "Lord, I am in danger again. I'm being threatened, and I am the only prophet left, and now Jezebel wants to kill me." Elijah was feeling pretty discouraged and sad, but God said to him, "Come outside with me. I want you to listen carefully." He said, "Stay here and you will feel the presence of God pass by you. Not just the voice, but the real presence of God will be with you." So Elijah goes outside and he stands on this beautiful mountaintop and waits. And first came a big strong wind. It was blowing trees down. It was so powerful. But Elijah felt nothing except the wind. And then the earth began to shake and the rocks began to break under his feet. It was an earthquake, but Elijah felt nothing except the trembling of the ground. And then a fire came, a great hot fire. But again, Elijah felt nothing except the hot on his face. And then it was quiet and Elijah waited. And as he waited in that quiet, he felt God in that peaceful quiet. He felt God right beside him. God knew and understood Elijah's heart right at that time. He knew Elijah was strong and he was brave. It wasn't that he was scared. It wasn't that he didn't want to be a prophet anymore. He was just saying, "What else can I do?" And God told him. He said, "I want you to go to the nearby town," told him exactly where to go. He said, "I want you to find a young man there named Elisha, and you will take off your coat and give it to Elisha." Back then, that was a sign that you were passing it on to them. Elisha would be the next prophet of God. Elisha would be the new voice of God. God had chosen Elisha just like he chose Elijah. God knows our hearts too, and he's always with us. Even when things are so loud and so crazy, we can't hear anything. He's still there waiting patiently for us, for that quiet, peaceful moment when he will say, "I'm here. I'm never going to leave you." Let's have our prayer. I hear you, God, even through all the noise. Your voice is louder than my TV. It's louder than all those car horns, louder than airplanes in the sky. Your presence is stronger than anything else, and I know you are there. I can feel you now. Amen. Y'all have a good week. Listen. Can you hear him?